In today's video, we're going to break down 5 awesome facts about the incredible Rottweiler. Welcome back to the Fenrir Rotty Show. If this is your first time here, my name's Will. I'm a canine behaviourist and the founder and CEO of FenrirCanineLeaders.com. Now, this channel is dedicated to helping you learn everything that you could ever possibly want to know about Rottweilers, then how to become high-level canine leaders that can raise perfect Rotty companions. So, if you're a lifelong Rottweiler lover, thinking about getting one, or you've just started your journey with a new Rottie puppy, then this channel is for you. So, make sure you hit that subscribe button, turn on the little notification bell so that you never miss a future Rottweiler video. So, let's dive into today's video. We'll break down 5 incredible and interesting facts about one of the world's most glorious dog breeds. And our fact at number 5 is that Rottweilers have a long and violent history. The Rottweilers we know today can proudly look back on a long and fascinating history. The origins of this world-famous guardian breed reach far back in time. They are one of Germany's most ancient dog breeds. Modern-day Rottweilers' ancestors were the feared Molossers of the Roman Empire. Dedicated, Mastiff-type war dogs. Absolutely fearless, these big, muscular dogs were bred and used to fight the enemies of the Empire. These loyal dogs battled and all too often died alongside the soldiers who owned them. When the Romans crossed the Alps with the purpose to conquer what is now known as Germany, they brought their trusted Mastiffs with them. Now, before too long, these Roman battle dogs started to interbreed with the local canine population, in particular the herding dogs, thereby forming the ancestor of today's Rottweiler. Now, after the collapse of the Roman Empire, the strong yet agile descendants of the Roman Molossus quickly gained popularity amongst the local farmers as herding dogs for sheep and cattle. So then, moving a little bit forward, during the World War, history repeated itself. Just like the Molossus ancestors, the Rottweiler was once again trained and utilised as a war dog, in this case to fight alongside German soldiers. Now, according to the veterans of World War II, many more lives would have been lost had it not been for the fearless dogs alerting them to ambushes. Fact number 4 is that Rotties are not Mastiffs. Now, despite those historical roots of the Molossus dogs of the Roman Empire, Rottweilers are not just another Mastiff breed. They are such a unique and distinctive working dog breed that they form a category of their own. However, in terms of physical prowess, they are no less powerful and naturally protective than the members of the Mastiff family, like your Bull Mastiffs, Connie Corstos, or English Mastiffs. Now, evidently, the Rottweiler is a large and powerful guardian dog. Naturally, muscular and compact in appearance. Despite the Rottweiler's long history, its basic temperament and appearance has not changed all too much over the last 120 years. The Rottie's first official German breed standard was established in 1901. Now, today's Rottweilers still carry many of the traits of their Mastiff-type ancestors, such as strong, substantially built, massive heads with that marked stop. Now, their height at the shoulder ranges from approximately 24 to 27 inches in the males and 22 to 25 inches in the females. That is about 61 to 69 centimetres and 56 to 64 centimetres. Now, the males tend to tip the scales upwards of 135 pounds or 100 pounds for females, and which is 61 kilos or 45 kilos, depending on where you live and what metric you use. Now, the official breed standard requires Rottweilers' athletic body to be well proportioned and neither too stocky nor too slim. Their short, easy to groom coat has to be solid black with clearly defined rust markings, which is known as the black and tan marking scheme. All these characteristics combined make for a very impressive physical appearance, and it should be quite obvious to anybody coming face to face with a Rottweiler, Mastiff or not, that this is not a dog to be messed with. Now, a fact at number 3 is that Rottweilers are official members of the police force. These athletic canines are not just natural guard dogs, but seriously brilliant working dogs. In the year 1910, Rottweilers were officially recognised as police service dogs. The extraordinary combination of physical prowess, intelligence, prey and natural guard drive, as well as trainability, found Rotties make for an extraordinarily efficient working dog breed. Now, without a doubt, these qualities are rooted in the Rottweiler's history. Back in ancient Germany, Germany, they were predominantly owned by cattle farmers and butchers who had come to recognize their immense strength, natural herding and guarding instincts, as well as their loyalty. Which, by the way, because of the predominant profession of their owners in those olden times, the Rottweiler is still called the Metzgerhund, which means butcher's dog in today's modern day Germany. But however, back in the day, the breed not only excelled in driving cattle to pastures and local markets, but also in effectively protecting animals from cattle thieves. Rottweil, a town in southern Germany, became the center for refining this unique breed and shaping it to the Rotties that we know and love today. Now, with the advent of the 19th century, the need of driving cattle over long distances rapidly decreased with the advent of railroad cattle cars. However, this did not hurt the breed. On the contrary, the versatile Rottweiler simply expanded into many different roles: police, military dogs, various guarding roles, search and rescue dogs, as well as, in more recent past, sporting dogs. Now, fact at number two is that Rottweilers were amongst the first search and rescue people after 9/11. As police service dogs, Rottweilers have proven themselves time and time again to be extremely reliable and capable. But what many people do not know is that the often feared Rottweiler also has a proven track record of saving many people's lives. Just one example of this is the tragedy of 9/11. Guess who was a part of the first search and rescue mission? Several Rottweilers were amongst over 300 rescue dogs that were sent into the ruins the days following September the 11th. They went into the fray alongside their handlers and got straight to work. As the search and rescue team leader Robert Yarnell would say later in an interview, the Rottweilers were the first search and rescue dogs at 9/11 at Ground Zero. Now, the Rottweilers watched our body language, and we could just give them hand signals to do what we needed them to do, and we couldn't have done it without them. So, one of the Rottweilers that went to Ground Zero to find survivors was a Rottweiler female named Callie, and she was unfortunately a casualty of 9/11. So last but not least, let's talk about, is the Rottweiler friend or foe? Well, the ancient butcher's dog of Rottweil is an amazing guardian and service dog. Powerful, beautiful, intelligent and versatile. And in the hands of experienced owners, the Rottweiler can and does unfold its full potential as a gifted, driven working dog. Always eager to please their owners, Rottweilers blossom in the right hands. They thrive when given tasks, when given ample physical as well as mental stimulation. Now, that said, it is a sad fact that accidents can and do happen. There has been numerous cases worldwide where Rottweilers have severely bitten or even killed both other dogs and humans. Especially tragic, of course, are the cases of children being harmed by these very strong and intense dogs. Unfortunately, it's not quite as simple as to say it's all the owner's fault. There are no bad dogs, only incapable owners. Now, anyone who has had the pleasure, like myself, to work with many Rottweilers can attest that the breed itself does have certain characteristics that will make it a little bit more high-risk candidate for such accidents than some other breeds. These characteristics are that strong prey drive, being so powerful and muscular, enormous bite force, natural guarding instincts, high levels of confidence, tendencies for natural dominance and independence, and aggression with that keen alertness. They are incredibly switched on and are always on the alert for something going wrong. So there is no doubt about it. A Rottweiler attacking a human is obviously the worst case scenario, as well as the nightmare of every owner. They are very, very strong and absolutely fearless. Just like the Rottie's war dog ancestors, they often will continue to fight and bite even when injured. Now, whilst the statistics we might find on Google may give an approximate overview of cases of Rottweilers biting other people, the real number of accidents is unfortunately much higher. Many owners get bitten by their own Rottweiler and then do not report this to authorities, wanting to avoid having their beloved dog put down, and it's those people that often come to me as a canine behaviourist seeking help and guidance. So although I absolutely love the glorious and incredible Rottweiler breed, and I can't wait to dedicate this whole channel to making as many videos as possible educating people on this breed, I want to ensure that people are always aware that you must be a high level canine leader before bringing this glorious breed into your home, so that you can assure that you are setting a positive example of what this breed can and should be, rather than adding to the statistics of where it can and does go wrong. So I hope you enjoyed our five facts today. If so, make sure you hit that like button, get involved down in the comment section below, and don't forget that if you are new here, to make sure that you subscribe. We have two dedicated Rottweiler videos coming here every single week. So I can't wait to talk to you again on the next episode of the Fenrir Rottie Show.